What's going on, boy? What, you've never seen a little person before?
No, I have, but you're me.
No, you're me.
No, you're me.
No, dude, you're me.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Whatever. Listen, I heard you got some coilovers. Brett told me you're gonna slam that Impreza.
Yeah, dude, I just picked them up like 2 weeks ago. I'm so excited.
Nice. When are you gonna do it?
I figure I'd do it like next week or something when I get time.
Next week? Where the fuck is that oatmeal?
Dude, it's not that big of a deal. You don't have to get to oatmeal.
Listen, dude, that's why your girl left you. You don't prioritize your time for things that matter.
Damn, dude. Fucking say it how it is.
Hey, man, I'm not gonna lie to you, alright? Go install those coilovers, slam that Impreza. I'm gonna show Miss Buttersworth a good time, okay?
Alright, I'm gonna go do it right now, okay?
Alright, go, now.
Alright, I'm gonna go do it right now.
Dude, we can totally put our Hot Wheels back here. There's so much room.
What's going on, guys? Today we are installing the BC Racing coilovers on the 2018 Subaru Impreza. Pulled it into the lift, gotta break the wheels. So right off the bat, I'm gonna show you how to install the front left coilover. This is what we're replacing, this big shock, this whole thing right here. Ideally, we would like to just take out those two bolts and be done, but there's all these wires you have to take off, brake line you have to take off, which I believe is held in by a bolt back here. So we're gonna start by taking the wires off, taking the brake line off, and then taking the main two bolts off.
So on the right side, you see what's holding this clip in. All you have to do is squeeze this little guy right here, push him through that way, and that'll be off.
After about 10 minutes playing with this clip, finally got it out. Basically, if you can see, it's got clips on each side, four sides of clips. You gotta press each side in as you start pulling out from each side, press in the other side, and just basically get it out of that hole right there. Now that that clip's off, the next thing you have to unhook is your brake line. Do not unhook it from the caliper, or else you'll find out the hard way. Yeah, so I just unhooked that and it started leaking everywhere. Do not do that. All you have to do is free it from this area back here, and then you're golden. To free up the brake line, you are going to need a 12 millimeter socket and start cranking. That's all you need to do. You just need to free it. You don't need to take off the brake or anything like that, and don't lose your bolts. The next part we have to take off. You see this black pole going straight up to right back up there? It's connected right there. If I felt it out correctly, it should be a 11/16 bolt. So get your 11/16, get it on there, and start cranking away. And this should be the last piece before we take out the two main bolts right there.
Yeah, buddy.
Okay, I ran into a little issue. As you get to the end of twisting this bolt off, as you twist it, the threading that it's on spins with it as well. How I'm combating that issue, by getting an Allen key. I don't know what size, but it's a fat one, snicketing in there and taking a wrench and slowly twisting it. But you see what I mean? Like, if I go to do it, it also twists the Allen key. So you gotta hold the Allen key and twist it. Long process, but you'll get it. And there it is. So before we take out these two main bolts right here, we're gonna put a jack underneath this. Because when you take out the bolts, this thing is gonna wanna drop. We're gonna put a jack under it, jack it up, take those bolts out. That's why you need the jack, so this gets held up. This whole brake mechanism gets held up, and now the suspension is free. Next step, go under the hood. So we are now under the hood.
top right, you'll see three bolts. That's what's holding your suspension on.
So we have to take these guys off, and then hopefully it pops out.
All right.
So I got the first one out.
Holy crap. Hopefully it's much easier for you now that you see my mistakes trying to do the wrench, unplugging the brake line. Don't do all that stuff. Hopefully it goes much more easy for you. But let's get this first one in. Let's go. Now that the new suspension's in, just gotta reverse your steps. Let's get started. This is why the jack is so crucial. Get it exactly where you need it. You know what I'm saying? All right, so I ran into a little snag. Come check this out. Full disclaimer, this is where you need to decide if you want to do a little more research to see if this is okay or not. But this is my fix. See if you can get in here a little bit. The sway bar, you see this thing moving? All right, so originally it will not fit. It's supposed to attach up here. Swing around to the right side. It's supposed to attach up here and it's not fitting. So if you want to do what I did, you unhook it on the other side and you'd be able to just twist it up just a bit and then it'll go right in like that. I don't know if that's okay or not, but that was my fix for it. I'm gonna do it anyway and hopefully the car doesn't break. But full disclaimer, look into that before you do it. I wanna thank my boy Impressive. His name is right here and that's his Instagram. He's the one who told me I'll run into some issues and he's the one that told me how to fix it. Thank you very much. Let's get back to it. We got both of the front coilovers on. I'm sweating my balls off. Brett,
you're sweating, you just got here.
I know, I'm already sweating, it's hot back here.
Do the honors, let's see. Oh shit, I can tell. Dude, when you lifted the car originally, it was like a foot wheel gap.
You're not even tucked either.
Well, let's put the lug nuts on. Wow. You only have to take off that little piece. I feel stupid. All right. So back to the rear, as I said. Just take that middle piece off. Those are the only two bolts you're gonna have to take off to get it off from the top. Because check it out. So see, on the rears, you only have two top bolts. Makes it much easier. So just take the two top bolts off, like right over there. And then all you're gonna have to do is take off this one bolt at the bottom, the far one, not the close one here, the far one. And then it's ready to take out. So what I'm gonna do for this bolt down here, come at it with the impact gun on the right side and the adjustable wrench on the left side. Woohoo! That's how you do that. Get that out of there. Okay, now that that bolt's out, you take these two off. This is the tough part. So it's very snug in there. I took the two bolts off from the top. I took the one big bolt off at the bottom. This is good if you have another person because you're gonna have to do this. All right, I'm gonna get on there. Oh my God, spider.
Let's go!
Ready?
Yeah, 2019. That's all I got, dude.
There we go.
Woo!
I told you, just a little more.
Yeah, baby!
All
right, let's put it back in.
Sometimes you need to ask one of the customers for help.
There's an STI?
I don't know how to drive a manual.
Where's our STI?
Hold on, wait, what's going on here?
I got him right now. Okay,
not me. All right, Brad, watch out.
I do.
Yeah. Hold up, hold up. Get right with you. I'ma get right with you. Bad bitches, fuck up, then dismiss them. Bad. I ain't really here to take no pictures.
Every time I see this car, it looks nicer and nicer.
So, it's the next day. The coilovers are installed. They are looking gorgeous. But here's the thing. I still have to lower it or raise it a little bit. We're not quite ready yet. But show them what it looks like.
We are low. Here's the thing. I definitely need to get new mud flaps because the mud flaps scrape hard. Like, I can't even drive without scraping the mud flaps.
If there's one modification that I've done to my car that makes it look the most different, it's the coilovers. So if you're in the market, if you're wondering if you should get coilovers or not, it makes the car look 10 times different, makes the car look so much more aggressive. And if you're in the game of modifying your car, coilover is not a bad way to go. That was the how-to video. That was the how-to video on installing BC Racing coilovers onto the 2018 Subaru Impreza. I make a new video every week, so make sure you go back, get caught up, watch all the other videos, and I will see you next week. Peace.